I want to tell you a little bit more about this relationship retreat that's coming up. And a lot of people ask, you know, or you think relationships and you think about a partner. But actually there's all kinds of relationships in our lives. And our first relationship starts when we're a baby with our mom or dad or caregiver. And the way that we are related to in the first 2 years of our lives actually determines in large part how we relate to people when we grow up. And so when you relate to your mother or your father or your siblings, certain parts of yourself may come out that are like really deep inside and might be different from how you relate to an acquaintance or a coworker, but they can set tones, they can set a pattern for how you are expected to be treated in relationships and how you treat others. And as well as friendships, right? So a lot of us growing up think times like middle school can be really challenging, you know, understanding friendships, and you have this hierarchy developing of who's the cool kid and who's not, and who's bullied. That can affect the way we relate to people. And then, you know, as we grow up, we're changing that relationship from being a child relating to adults to being an adult ourselves and relating to other adults. But you still have all these different power hierarchies. You might have a boss, you might have a coworker, you might be a manager of other people. And how do you relate to all of those people? And then we definitely do, you know, run into partners and intimate personal relationships. And how do you relate to those? And friendships. Like, I've noticed that friendships for me have really changed between people that I went to school with and it was convenient. And then as I grow older and explore my own path and my own values, I realize that those people who might have been close to me, I am not really close to them anymore. I had a time when I was 25, I had my birthday and I had 3 best friends. When I turned 26, I didn't speak to any of those 3 best friends, and it was really disorienting and really lonely. But when I did that, I made space for other people to come into my life that are so much closer. And now I have really strong, nourishing sister and brother, spiritual-based relationships where we really connect in an intimate way because of the shared values that we have. And, you know, as an adult, I've also negotiated my relationship with my parents now, as no longer being a child. And, you know, getting to that point later on where we as adult children will, you know, be taking care of our parents. That's a different role that we have in life. So just want to share all the different kinds of relationships that we have. And of course, the most important one is with ourselves. How do you treat yourself? How do you talk to yourself? A lot of times what we say about ourselves, we would never even say that about a friend because it would sound really mean. And so I think that coming together in this space with other women to really share, to get into ourselves, to listen and be heard, is really nourishing. It's a really important lesson that we don't get out in life. We don't get a lot of time to talk about relationships, process them, and really come together so that we can have fulfilling and inspiring relationships in our life. So I hope to see you in 2 weeks in Vermont. Thank you.